Everybody, Teacher Source here. I wanted to show you my new book clubs product. Now, all of the resources in this book club product I've utilized and created throughout my years of teaching. And I've just been doing book clubs. I believe this was our third year. And how we've been doing book clubs has kind of evolved every single year and also depends on your students and their level of conversation, their reading levels, all sorts of different things. So it almost looks different every year, but this is just kind of like a startup guide for you to start up your book clubs. If you've done book clubs in the past, you can utilize these resources to change it up. If you've never done book clubs, this is kind of a good guide for you just to start them up and see how they go. And so the video that I'm on right now, I'm going to be posting the link on the page too. So if you want to go back and see anything again, I will have that link for you there. So basically the first step in book clubs is leveling and picking your books. So you need to look at the reading levels in your class and then figure out your groups. And I would not recommend exceeding 5 students in a reading book club when they're, you know, on their own by themselves running their own book clubs, because obviously too many people, there's too many cooks in the kitchen, way too many kids, and then students kind of get lost in the conversation. I personally like groups of 4 because I just like even numbers. And also another thing you need to think about is, do you have a book room? Do you have a library? And where can you find multiple copies of a text? Because every single child in the group needs to have the text. Nowadays, a lot of classes are one-to-one with computers. So you could utilize like Epic Books, Reading A to Z, different resources like that, where students can be logging on and either listening to the story if they're a lower level reader, but have good listening comprehension. And that way that would help them be able to talk about the book, but not necessarily relying on their reading skills. Or you could have the kids actually physically reading books online as well. So lots of different options, but there is a link here where you can go to this file on Google Links, and you'll be able to find these 2 charts, and you can type in your student's name and use this chart if you would like. Or obviously you can handwrite in it as well. So you're going to need to put your student, the reading levels that you work with in your class, and then your students who are in those reading levels, and then try to configure your groups based on that. Or another idea is you can group the kids by interest level. So, you know, if you have a group of kids who like soccer, a group of kids who really love dogs, and then that can base your search for what type of books they would like to read. And then obviously your groups then would be various reading levels, and so you're going to need to figure out, you know, maybe those lower level readers can listen to the book, or kids in the group can read the book to the other person. So lots of different ways to utilize this. It just all depends on your clientele. And then you're going to want to talk about what a book club is, because chances are students have not necessarily done book clubs before if they're in like a third grade level. So you need to establish what it is and what it isn't. And you can go on YouTube and search like book club video, and there's a lot of resources out there to utilize. Or if you've done book clubs in the past, what I like to do is I'll show a video of my prior students from years past, kind of like as the exemplar. And what I have my students do is they all get a post-it note out and they write down what they're noticing while I'm playing the video. What are the kids doing? What supplies do they have? What are they talking about? And then we discuss together as a class, and you can find this book clubs do and don't form here in this link. And you could utilize this to come up with the list of what the book clubs shouldn't be doing and what they should be doing. And what you can do is you can copy this then after you make it as a class and put it in their book club folder. So that way it's always in their book clubs and they have that reminder of what they establish as a class, what a book club looks like. And then you're going to want the students to establish their own club. So once you tell the students, hey, you're in, you know, blue, this club or whatever it is, and these are the kids in your group, you're going to want them to establish their club name, their symbol, member names, rules, make it like an actual club so that they feel, you know, obligated to want to contribute to their book club and have conversations with their book club members. And the link to this next chart that I'm going to show you, there's a Google link and a Seesaw link. So if you're a Seesaw classroom, you could have each group created on there, so they could do more of a drawing thing or whatever you see fit for your class. But this is the chart you're going to want to use. They're going to come up with a club name, the rules, who's in the club, a little symbol for themselves, and then I put in a hashtag. Kids love hashtags, so they can come up with their own like hashtag or cheer or whatever they want to come up with for their club. And then what I like to do is I'll use this paper and I staple it to the front of the book club folder that you're going to need for each book club. Each book club is going to need, and this is all talked about in the PDF, each book club is going to need a folder where they're going to keep different various organizers and things. They're going to need post-it notes, pencils, and then some sort of a bin where you can keep all of this, because they're also going to put the books that they're reading for the book club in this bin. I don't exactly know what they're called, but I have this big shelving, rolling shelf thing that are like a rainbow colors of bins. Teachers out there, I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. I can't think of the name of them, but I just pick those bins out of there, and that's what I use for my book clubs, and they seem to be a perfect size. So you're going to want to figure out what books the kids want to read. So you're going to do a book tasting, and this was super fun, and I really like jazzed this up and made it really exciting and animated for the kids. But each book club group, you're going to want to pick 3 different books that they can choose from in this book tasting. You want to give them a variety again so that they're the ones in charge of choosing what type of book they want to read collectively as a group. So what you're going to give each kid, and this is all in the directions here, you're going to want to lay out these placemats. And so if you have 5 groups of 4, you're going to set up little like tables where there's going to be 4 of these set up at a table. And you're going to have the books pre-picked out for each group. So what I did is I had in my back table, each of my groups, I had the 3 different books laid out. And I used a tray. I don't know if you can see this. This is just like the top of a big bin in my classroom. And I use that as my serving tray. You can also get a tray from like the, whatchamacallit, the cafeteria, and to put the books on. And so I turned on like Italian restaurant music, and while the kids are at specials, I set this all up, had it all ready to go. And when the kids came back, I said, please go get your colors and pencil and line back up in the hallway. And so then I said, like, all right, table 1, Tommy, Susie, Courtney, and Bryant, come on and join me. Your table is ready. And I brought the book club group to their table, quote unquote. And then I did that with the rest of the groups. And then I said, okay, I'm going to come around now with your appetizer. And that was the first book for each book club group. And so a step that I missed prior to that is I let the kids, and it's up to you, I let the kids decorate their little placemat. And you can make this like as long as you want or as short as you want, but sorry that I missed that step. And so then I am all about timers, especially with, I teach 3rd grade, but setting a time limit is key and having it visual in the classroom, because otherwise the kids could color probably for 8 hours if you let them. But setting that timer, saying, all right, I'm giving you 5 minutes, you're going to color it, and when the 5 minutes is up, we're done, we're moving on, and visually posting that in the class. So, like I said before, I set a timer, and right here, I said I come out and set a timer for 2 minutes, and I bring around the appetizer book. And the students, what they do is they just look at the appetizer book, look at the cover, read a few pages for 2 minutes. And when that timer goes off, I give them this paper, and obviously it's hard to see because this is sideways, but they're going to fill this paper out about that specific book that they just looked at, what the title was, what tastes good about the book, what predictions can they make, would you like to read this book, and why. They're not going to fill in this rating box. And then you're going to go back as the waitress, clear the table like a waitress would, and take the appetizer away. And then you're going to do the same thing. As before, but before you do that, you're going to set a timer for 3 minutes, and the book club is going to talk about that book. So whatever book they just read, they're going to get 3 minutes on the clock to say, you know, based on that paper that they were taking notes on, did they like the book, predictions, again, not filling the rating out yet. Then you're going to do the same thing. You're going to pass out now the main course books. It's the second book for each book club. Timer for 2 minutes for the kids to look over the book, 2 minutes to fill out the book tasting page, and then 3 minutes to discuss, clear the tables. Then you're going to give them their dessert book, and then they're going to Again, get 2 minutes to look at the book. Then they're going to write about it for 2 minutes, and then they're going to discuss the book for 3 minutes. And you can adjust those times based on your students. Totally up to you. Those are just my suggestions. And then you're going to give them some time to discuss which book they think they would like the best. So they're going to rate the books by themselves first. And they're going to say, okay, I like this book number one, this book was number three, and this book was number two. One meaning they would like to read that book the most, three being the least. And then their group is going to discuss, hey, I gave one to Rainbow Fish. Okay, I gave a one to Because of Winn-Dixie. Whatever the books are, they're going to discuss and try to collectively come up with which book they would want to read. You might have some sad friends in the group because they didn't necessarily want to read that book, but please, you can reassure them that when they finish this first book, you're going to have those other books on deck and they will get a chance to read those books as well.